奉主耶稣圣名正道。
In the name of Jesus, I speak.
按照所编排的，今天晚上我们要来谈有关圣餐礼的道理。
According to the plan, we are going to discuss about the Holy Communion tonight.
圣餐礼对基督徒来说是一个重要的典礼。
The Holy Communion is an important sacrament to Christians.
因为这是主耶稣亲自设立并且吩咐门徒要遵守的。
Because this was personally instituted by the Lord Jesus, and he also instructed the disciples to keep it.
我们请看路加福音22章。
Let us turn to Luke chapter 22.
19跟20节。
Luke chapter 22 verses 19 and 20. Luke chapter 22 verses 19 and 20. Verse 19. And he took bread,gave thanks and broke it and gave it to them saying, This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Verse 20. Likewise, he also took the cup after supper saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood which is shed for you.
主耶稣设立圣餐的目的就是要我们来纪念他。
The purpose the Lord Jesus instituted the Holy Communion was for us to remember Him.
纪念他为我们的罪而死。
To remember that He died for our sins.
纪念他的宝血赦免我们的罪，使我们能够成为神的儿女。
To remember that it is His blood that has cleansed us of our sins, which is why we can be His children.
他用他的宝血与我们立约，使我们将来可以承受永生，进入神的国。
And he made a covenant with his blood so that we can enter into his kingdom in the future.
所以举办圣餐典礼纪念主的死，这是一个很重要的事情。
Therefore, to keep the Holy Communion, to remember his death is very important.
既然是这么的重要，那么我们有没有遵照主的吩咐去做呢？
Since this Holy Communion is so important, have we kept the words of the Lord to keep it?
主耶稣说，你们也应当如此行。
And the Lord Jesus told the disciples, do this.
如此行并不只是说要纪念主的死而已。
And the Lord Jesus said, do this, it is not just to remember his death.
也要按照主所行的去行。
And it also tells us to do it in the way that the Lord Jesus did it.
当时主耶稣怎么样设立这个圣餐，执行这个圣餐，今天我们也要按照主所行的来去行。
And in the past, how the Lord Jesus instituted the Holy Communion, how he carried it out, we should follow the same today.
如果每一个人都按照主所行的去行，
And if everyone follows what the Lord Jesus did,
圣餐典礼只有一种的方式，没有很多种的方式。
Then there is only one way of keeping the Holy Communion. There are not many ways.
可是为什么今天不同的基督教派，他们都有不同方式的圣餐典礼呢？
But the question is why is it that different Christian denominations keep it differently?
那你就发觉到有一些人他并不是按照主所行的去行，他们按照人的意思随意去行。
Then you will realize that not all Christians keep it in accordance to the way that the Lord Jesus kept it.
如果是这么样重要的一个圣餐典礼，
If the Holy Communion is so important,
我们能够按照人自己的方式来去举办吗？
Can we hold the Holy Communion according to our own way?
尤其是主耶稣已经亲自做一个榜样给我们看。
Moreover, the Lord Jesus himself has set an example for us to follow.
那我们岂不是更应当按照主的方式来去举办吗？
Should we not all the more keep it according to the way that the Lord Jesus kept it?
所以保罗他这样的强调。
Therefore, Paul emphasized this.
哥林多前书第十一章
First Corinthians chapter 11
23跟24节
First Corinthians chapter 11 verses 23 and 24 For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus on the same night in which he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
当保罗在谈论到圣餐道理的时候，
When Paul was discussing concerning the teachings of the Holy Communion,
他强调这是从主领受的。
He emphasized here that this he received from the Lord.
每一个使徒都按照主所行的去行。
In fact, every apostle kept the Holy Communion in accordance to the manner in which the Lord Jesus kept it.
你想想看，如果不同的使徒他们这边啊，这样也不要紧啊，那样也不要紧啊，每一个人就按自己的方便来举办这个圣餐的话，你就会发觉到也有很多种不同的圣餐方式了。
Now, if each of the apostles decided to keep it in the manner that he thought was right, each of them decided that this could be done away with or that could be done away with, then there would be different holy communions kept by the apostles.
但是他们都知道。
But all of the apostles knew.
这是主所吩咐的。
This was instructed personally by Jesus.
而且叫我们要按照他所行的去行。
And therefore,And since the Lord also instructed them to keep it in the same manner.
那么圣餐里最重要的就是这个饼和这个杯。
In fact, during the Holy Communion, the two most important components are the bread and the cup.
那个饼是要用无酵饼。
The bread must be made with unleavened bread.
在哥林多前书第五章。
1 Corinthians chapter 5.
第七跟第八节。
Verses 7 and 8. 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 7 and 8.Verse 7, therefore purge out the old leaven, that you may be a new lump, since you truly are unleavened. For indeed Christ our Passover was sacrificed for us. Verse 8, therefore let us keep the feast, not with old leaven, nor with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth.
第七节告诉我们，既然基督的宝血洁净了我们，那我们就应当不要再去犯罪，成为一个无效的面。
Verse 7 tells us that since the blood of Jesus has forgiven us of our sins, let us not continue to sin, let us be an unleavened bread.
但是这并不只是教训而已。
But this is not just a teaching.
在我们举办圣餐的时候，
When we keep the Holy Communion,
这个饼也是要用无效饼。
The bread must beAn unleavened bread.
就像当时他们守的逾越节。
Just like the Passover that the Israelites kept.
那同时也是无酵节的开始。
In fact, it was also the beginning of the feast of the unleavened bread.
一连七天不可以有酵。
For a period of 7 days, they could not eat leaven.
所以保罗告诉我们。
Therefore, Paul tells us.
今天我们守这个节。
Today, when we keep this feast,
我们守这个圣餐典礼，这个属灵的逾越节。
When we keep the Holy Communion, which is the spiritual Passover,
来纪念主这个羔羊为我们的罪而死。
To remember Christ, the Passover, who was sacrificed for us.
那我们用的饼应该是无酵饼。
Then the bread that we use should be an unleavened bread.
如果你用面包已经发了酵的来取代，那就已经失去了这个意义，也违背了这个无罪的意义了。
If you use bread that is leavened bread, then you would have gone against the significance of being without sin.
并且只是用一个饼，并不是用很多个饼。
Secondly, you can only use one bread. You cannot use many pieces of bread.
我们请看第十章。
Let's turn also to chapter 10.
哥林多前书的第十章。
First Corinthians chapter 10.
16跟17节。
Verses 16 and 17. First Corinthians chapter 10, verses 16 and 17. Verse 16. The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not the communion of the blood of Christ?The bread which we break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ?
保罗在这里强调。
Paul emphasizes here.
虽然我们人数很多。
Verse 17, for we though many.
当我们举办这个圣餐的饼还是一个饼。
But when we partake of the Holy Communion, we use only one bread.
为什么要用一个饼呢？
Why do we use only one bread?
因为基督只有一个身体。
Because Christ has only one body.
我们领受这个饼就是领受主的身体。
And when we partake of this bread, we partake of the body of Christ.
如果你用很多饼来取代一个饼。
If you use many pieces of bread instead of one,
你认为不要紧，反正我们人这么多嘛。
You think to yourself, it doesn't matter, because we have so many people.
那么你就已经违背了这个代表一个身体这个意义。
Then you would have gone against the significance of this one bread.
如果不要紧，保罗也不需要再这样的强调。
If this was not important, then Paul would not have emphasized it here.
如果人多，我们就把饼做大一点。
If there are many of us, then we can make the bread bigger.
如果人少，我们就做小一点。
And if there are fewer people, we make the bread smaller.
大饼或者小饼仍然是一个饼。
Whether it is large or small, as long as it is one piece of bread,
代表基督一个身体。
Then it signifies that Jesus Christ has only one body.
可是如果你为了方便用很多饼来取代的时候，那已经违背那个意义了。
But if for convenience sake you use many pieces of bread, then you would have gone against the teaching of Christ.
那么那个杯呢？
What about the cup?
不是用葡萄酒，而是用葡萄汁。
You cannot use wine, you have to use grape juice.
我们请看马太福音的26章。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 26.
29节
Matthew chapter 26 verse 29 Matthew chapter 26 verse 29 verse 29 But I say to you, I will not drink of this fruit of the vine from now on until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom.
我们再读马可福音14章
Let us turn also to Mark chapter 14
25节
verse 25 Mark chapter 14 verse 25. Assuredly I say to you, I will no longer drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God.
圣经强调主耶稣举办圣餐所用的是葡萄汁。
The Bible emphasizes that Jesus used grape juice when he conducted the Holy Communion.
虽然葡萄酒是他们日用的饮品。
Even though wine was a common beverage in those times,
可是在举办圣餐的时候用的是葡萄汁。
But during the conducting the Holy Communion, they used grape juice.
也许你可以辩论说，那个英文的是从葡萄来的，那葡萄酒也是从葡萄来的。
Perhaps you might argue that in English it says fruit of the vine, since wine also comes from the fruit of the vine.It is the same.
所以葡萄酒也好，葡萄汁也好，都不要紧，都是从葡萄来的。
So you might say, whether it is grape juice or wine, they all come from the vine.
但是你要知道，当时逾越节也同时就是除酵节的开始，不可以有发酵的东西，那就怎么会用葡萄酒呢？
But you must understand that it was the Passover at that time, and therefore they cannot eat anything that had leaven. How could they have used wine?
所以我们遵照主耶稣所行的，饼用无酵饼，杯用葡萄汁。
And therefore we follow the teaching of Christ. The bread, we have to use unleavened bread, and for the drink, we have to use grape juice.
我们认为重要，因为这是主所吩咐的。
We think it is important precisely because the Lord Jesus commanded it.
你认为不重要是根据什么呢？
But if you think it is unimportant, what is your basis for saying so?
那是根据你的思想认为不重要。
Then it is according to your own thinking.
那我们来比较一下。
Then let us compare.
你说听主的话去行好呢，还是按照你的意思去做不要紧比较好？
Do you think it is more important to follow the teaching of Christ, or is it better to follow your own thinking?
我们都很清楚知道。
We know the answer for ourselves.
我们应该听从主的吩咐。
We should follow the teaching of Christ.
既然圣餐典礼是这么样的重要。
Since the Holy Communion is so important.
那我们是不是遵照主所行的去行呢？
The question is, have we followed the teaching of Christ?
但是圣餐典礼还有另外一个重要的道理。
But there is another important teaching with regards to the Holy Communion.
圣餐典礼并不只是纪念主的死而已。
The Holy Communion is not just a remembrance of the Lord's death.
更重要的是要同领主的身体、主的血。
It is to partake of the body and the blood of Christ.
请看哥林多前书的第十章。
Let's turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 10.
16节。
Verse 16. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 16. Verse 16. The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not the communion of the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ?
保罗在这里特别的强调。
Paul emphasizes here.
我们领受圣餐并不只是纪念主的死。
When we partake of the Holy Communion, it is not just a remembrance of the Lord's death.
我们是同领基督的血，我们是同领基督的身体。
In fact, it is a communion of the blood of Christ, it is also a communion of the body of Christ.
这是一个很重要的道理。
This is a very important teaching.
如果你在领受圣餐的时候，
If when you partake of the Holy Communion,
你如果不分辨这是主的身体主的血，
and you do not discern that this is the body and blood of Christ,
你只是当作一个普通的仪式，
and you treat it like a, just a, something that is common,
你只要纪念主替我们为我们死就好了，
it, to you it is just a remembrance of the Lord's death,
并不是真的领受主耶稣的身体，主耶稣的血。
And you do not think that it is a, you are really partaking of the body and the blood of Christ.
保罗说，那这样你就犯罪了。
In fact, Paul tells us that if this is so, you would have sinned.
你是吃喝自己的罪。
You would have eaten or you have brought judgment and sin upon yourself.
是什么罪呢？
What sin is that?
干犯主的身体，主的血。
It is to have sinned against the body and the blood of Christ.
这并不是一个很严重的问题哦。
In fact, this is something that is very serious.
我们怎么敢去干犯主的身体、主的血呢？
How would we dare to sin against the body and the blood of Christ?
什么时候我们会干犯主的身体、主的血呢？
In fact, when would we sin against the body and the blood of Christ?
请看十一章。
Let's turn to chapter 11.
哥林多前书的十一章。
Chapter 11.
27跟到29节。
27 to 28. Therefore, whoever eats this bread or drinks this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup.
保罗在这里说得很清楚。
Paul tells us very clearly here.
无论谁，如果他不按理吃主的饼和主的杯，就是干犯主的身、主的血了。
Verse 27 says, whoever it is, whoever eats of the bread and drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord.
不按理是什么意思？
What does it mean to eat and drink in an unworthy manner?
是不是我们领受的时候歪歪这样躺坐这样来吃？
Is it our posture when we partake of the Holy Communion?
或者是你在吃的时候一边讲话，哎，今天晚上等下我们去哪里啊？然后阿门吃这个饼。
Or is it because you are chit-chatting as you partake of the Holy Communion?
是不是讲这些态度的问题？
Is it talking about just attitude?
不是的。
No.
保罗解释那个原因。
In fact, Paul tells us what it means to eat in an unworthy manner.
29节。
Verse 29.
因为人吃喝若不分辨是主的身体，就是吃喝自己的罪了。
Verse 29, he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner, eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body.
所以28节说，你应当自己审查，然后才吃这个饼喝这个杯。
Therefore, Paul tells us in verse 28, let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup.
审查，你真的相信这是主的身体，主的血吗？
Examine yourself to see whether you believe that this is truly the body and the blood of Christ.
你现在领受的是什么？
What are you partaking now?
为什么你要领受？
Why are you partaking it?
这只是一个饼吗？
Is this just normal bread?
这只是一个葡萄汁吗？
Is this just normal grape juice?
如果你把它当作是平常的，
If you treat it as something common,
你不分辨这是主的身体，那么你就是吃喝自己的罪了。
You do not discern that this is the Lord's body, then you drink judgment to yourself.
你就是干犯主的身、主的血了。
Then you will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord.
有些人说，
Some people say,
不是的，那是因为那些领受圣餐的人哦，有一些人喝醉酒。
Some people say that it is because some of the Christians in Corinth were drunk when they partook of the Holy Communion.
因为21节里面不是谈到吗？那一些人还没有领受圣餐的时候啊，他们就先吃自己的饭，先喝自己的酒，而且喝醉了。
Then verse 21 says that some of them ate before they partook of the Holy Communion. In fact, some of them got drunk.
所以他们这样的态度很不好。
And therefore, such an attitude was wrong.
所以保罗责备他们。
Which is why Paul criticizes them.
在30节这样记载。
Verse 30.
他说，因此你们中间有好些软弱的，已犯病的，死的也不少。
For this reason, many are weak and sick among you, and many sleep.
那么这些人通通都是喝酒来领受圣餐，所以被刑罚吗？
But does it mean that all of them got drunk while they were partaking the Holy Communion, which is why God judged them?
不是啊。
No.
保罗不是这个意思。
Paul did not mean this.
保罗接下去就解释了，因为你们领受不分辨这是主的身体主的，那么就是吃了自己的罪。
In fact, Paul explains in the passage here that it was because they did not discern the Lord's body, which is why they drink, eat and drink judgment to themselves.
你喝到醉醺醺的，连你姓什么都忘记了，你怎么知道现在领受的是主的身体、主的血？
In fact, when you get drunk, you cannot even discern what you are eating. How can you discern that that is the Lord's body?
那你就真的是干犯这个主的身体、主的血了。
Then you will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord.
所以神管教他们。
Which is why God judged them.
所以保罗纠正他们。
And Paul corrected them.
因此，领受圣餐不只是纪念主的死。
Therefore, partaking of the Holy Communion is not just a remembrance of the Lord's death.
更重要是同领主的身体、主的血。
More importantly, it is a communion in the body and the blood of Christ.
这个道理并不是保罗解释的。
In fact, this teaching is not only explained by Paul.
这个道理是主耶稣亲自说明的。
In fact, this was personally taught by the Lord Jesus Christ.
请看约翰福音第六章。
Let's turn to John chapter 6.
我们读53到56节。
Let's read 53 to 56. John chapter 6 verses 53 to 56. Then Jesus said to them, Most assuredly I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me.And I in him.
我们听到主耶稣多次的强调，我们要吃主的肉，要喝主的血。
We see the Lord Jesus emphasizing once and again to eat his flesh and to drink his blood.
并且告诉我们这是多么样的重要。
And he also tells us that this is very important.
你不吃喝人子的肉和血，你就没有生命在你们里面。
He who does not eat my flesh and drink my blood has no life in you.
吃我肉喝我血的人就有永生，在末日我要叫他复活。
Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day.
他再强调。
And again he emphasizes.
我的肉真是可吃的，我的血真是可喝的。
For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed.
他越强调，就越让那些人听到越反感。
And the more the Lord Jesus emphasized, the more put off the listeners were.
我们以为我们听错了。
They thought that we had listened wrongly.
我们怎么能够吃人的肉喝人的血呢？
How can we eat of man's flesh and drink of man's blood?
这是违背神的道理的。
Isn't this against the teaching?Of God.
但是他却再三的来强调。
But Jesus emphasized once and again.
所以在第六十节这样记载。
Therefore, verse 60.
不要说一般人不能够接受啊，他的门徒中好些人听见就说，这个话很难，谁能够听呢？
And let's not talk about the others who could not accept it. Verse 60 tells us that many of his disciples exclaimed, This is a hard saying, who can understand it?
不但是当时的人很难接受。
In fact, not only people then could not accept.
今天基督教里面也有很多的人很难接受。
In fact, there are many Christians today who cannot accept this teaching.
因此对吃主的肉和主的血就产生不同的辩论，不同的解释。
And therefore, there are debates over what it means to eat of the flesh and drink of his blood.
甚至也因此造成教会的分裂。
And this has resulted in divisions in the church.
比如当时马丁路德跟慈运里他们是两个改革宗教的出名的领袖。
For example, we know that Martin Luther and Zwingli were famous leaders during the Reformation.
这两个人同心合一的改革宗教，要把信徒带回到圣经里面去。
Both of them were united in reforming the church to bring the disciples back to the teachings of the Bible.
他们成功了。
They were successful.
但是以后为了辩论这个圣餐的道理，他们意见不同，结果两个人也分裂了。
But later on, both of them argued over the teaching of the Holy Communion, and both of them parted ways.
马丁路德就成立了他的路德宗，那么慈运里就成立他的改革宗。
Martin Luther started the Lutheran Church, and Zwingli started the Reformed Church.
因为他们两个人对圣餐主的肉主的血有不同的解释。
Because both of them had different explanations with regards to what it means to eat of the flesh and to drink of his blood.
迟云里他不认为这真的是主的肉主的血。
Zwingli felt that this was not really the flesh and the blood of Christ.
当你注谢这个饼和血这个杯以后，
When you bless the bread and the cup,
这个饼和这个血一样是饼，这个饼和这个葡萄酒一样是饼和葡萄酒，没有什么改变。
He felt that the bread and the cup remains as bread and grape juice. There is no change.
不过注谢以后的饼和酒有一个关系。
But there is a relationship after they bless the bread as well as the cup.
是什么关系呢？
And what was that relationship?
那就是代表主的身体和主的血。
And that relationship was that it symbolizes the body and the blood of Christ.
当主耶稣说这是我的饼，就说这是代表我的身体的意思。
And when he felt that when the Lord Jesus said, this is my body, he meant only this symbolizes my body.
他也有一个很好的理由。
In fact, he had a very strong reason for saying this.
他说当主耶稣设立圣餐的时候，
He says that when the Lord Jesus established the Holy Communion,
他根本都还没有钉在十字架上。
The Lord Jesus had not yet been nailed on the cross.
他都还没有死啊。
The Lord Jesus had not yet died.
所以他怎么样把他的肉和血给人家给他们吃呢？
So his argument was that how could he have given the people or his disciples his flesh and his blood?
可见的当时主耶稣说这是我的身体的时候，他人都还活着啊。
And therefore you see that when the Lord Jesus says that this is my body, he was still alive.
所以这个解释说这是代表我的身体。
So his explanation was that this only symbolized my body.
马丁路德他不同意这样的解释。
Martin Luther disagreed with Zwingli.
他说经过注谢以后，
He felt that after blessing,
主物质的肉跟物质的血就立刻跟这个物质的饼物质的葡萄酒同在，或者叫做共存。
The physical body after blessing, the physical body and the physical blood of Jesus exists simultaneously with the physical bread and the physical cup, and this is called consubstantiation.
所有领受圣餐的人，他们都是真实的领受主物质的肉物质的血。
And those who partake, he felt that those who partake of the Holy Communion partook of the physical body and the physical blood of Jesus.
因为主耶稣说，我的肉是真是可吃的，我的血真是可喝的。
Because the Lord Jesus says here, my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed.
主没有说这是代表，他反而说这是一个真实的。
The Lord Jesus did not say this symbolizes my flesh, or this symbolizes my blood, but he says this is food indeed.
可是他补充解释。
But Martin Luther adds on.
可是你们不要误会，这个饼变成主耶稣的身体，这个葡萄酒变成主耶稣的血。
But do not be mistaken that this body, this bread has changed into the body of Jesus, and this cup has changed into the blood of Jesus.
注谢以后，饼还是饼，葡萄酒还是葡萄酒。
After blessing, the bread is still the bread, and the wine is still the wine.
不同的就是主物质的肉、物质的血跟这个物质的饼啊，同时存在了。
The only difference is that the physical body of Jesus abides simultaneously with the physical bread.
他也有很好的理由。
He also has a very strong reason for saying this.
他说主活着的时候，他的肉身里面有神性和人性共存。
He argued that when Jesus was alive, Jesus was fully man as well as fully God.
而且主耶稣里面的神性和人性是个别完整保存的。
And he argued that the divinity of Jesus as well as the humanity of Jesus was fully preserved in the body of Jesus.
他们并不是合在一起，但是他们是个别同时共存的。
it is not united together, but it exists simultaneously together.
既然是这样，
since this is the case,
在圣餐里也是这样的道理。
His argument is that the Holy Communion holds the same teaching.
所以祝谢以后，
and therefore he argued that after blessing,
主物质的肉和物质的血就同时跟这个物质的饼和酒共存了。
The physical blood and the physical body of Jesus abides together with the physical bread and physical wine.
天主教的解释，
What about the explanation of the Roman Catholics?
他不承认这是象征的，他也不承认这是共存或者合制的。
The Roman Catholics do not recognize this as symbolic, neither do they recognize this as consubstantiation.
他说经过注谢以后，
They say that after blessing,
这个饼就变成主耶稣的肉，这个葡萄酒就变成主耶稣的血了。
And they argue that the bread turns into the body of Jesus, and the wine turns into the blood of Jesus.
所以他们认为这不是合制，这是变制，实在的变制。
And therefore they see this not as a unifying of a substance, but a change in substance.
这个编制说是在1215年在他们的拉提兰会议才正式决定的。
In fact, this concept of transubstantiation was decided in 1215 in the Lateran Council.
那可见的之前大部分不同意这样的解释。
And therefore we see that before this council, most of the people did not agree on such an explanation.
可是这个会议以后他们宣布，
But after this council, the Roman Catholics declared,
基督的身体和血实在包含在饼和酒里面。
That the body of Christ and the blood of Christ, its substance is in the bread and in the wine.
简单说，饼变成主的肉，葡萄酒变成主的血。
And simple words, the bread turns into the body of Christ, and the wine turns into the blood of Christ.
当然，我们教会不同意这一些解释。
And for our church, we disagree with such explanations.
我们不同意只是象征主的身体和主的血。
We disagree that this is only symbolic of the body and the blood of Christ.
正如马丁路德的反驳，
Just as what Martin Luther said.
他说主说得很清楚，我的肉真是可吃的，我的血真是可喝的。
In fact, Jesus says here very clearly that my flesh is food indeed and my blood is drink indeed.
这不是象征，这是一个真实的。
This is not symbolic, this is real.
虽然他说主耶稣都还没有受死啊，怎么有可能他的肉和血给我们吃呢？
Even though Zwingli argued that since Jesus has not yet died, how could he have given his body and blood for the disciples to eat and drink?
这就是主耶稣所解释的。
And this is why Jesus explains it in this manner.
当他们不能够领受吃主的肉喝主的血的时候，
When the disciples could not accept eating and drinking of the body and blood of Christ,
主耶稣怎么样向他们解释呢？
How did Jesus answer the disciples?
我们读63跟64节。
Let's read verses 63 and 64.
约翰福音第六章，
John chapter 6,
63跟64节。
63 and 64. It is the spirit that gives life, the flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are spirit and they are life, but there are some of you who do not believe. For Jesus knew from the beginning who they were who did not believe and who would betray him.
主耶稣在这里说明，我讲的并不是物质的肉，物质的血。
The Lord Jesus explains here very clearly that he is not talking about physical flesh and physical blood.
他所讲的是灵里变化的肉，灵里变化的血。
In fact, he is talking about spiritual flesh and blood.
我所说的话就是灵，就是生命。
The words that I speak to you are spirit and they are life.
当主这样说的时候，就这样的成就。
And because the Lord Jesus said this, it happened.
所以当主耶稣对门徒说，
And therefore when the Lord Jesus told the disciples,
这是我的身体，
This is my body.
这就真的成为主的身体。
Then it really became The body of Christ.
不是在物质上，因为耶稣的物质身体都还活着啊，怎么样是物质的肉呢？
And it is, therefore it is not physically the flesh of Jesus, because Jesus was still physically alive.
但这是在灵里变化的。
But there is a change in spirit.
我们看不到，但我们相信。
We cannot see such a change, but we believe.
根据什么来相信呢？
And what is our basis for belief?
根据主耶稣的话。
It is based on the words of Jesus.
他说这是我的身体。
He says, this is my body.
他没有说这是代表我的身体。
He did not say this symbolize my body.
他说这是我的身体。
He says, this is my body.
那我的话就是灵，就是生命。
And Jesus says here, my words are spirit and they are life.
你们吃我的肉喝我的血就有永生，在末日我要叫你复活。
Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day.
所以我们也不能够同意吃马丁路德或者天主教所说的合之说或者是变质说。
And therefore we also disagree with Martin Luther propounded, that is consubstantiation, or what the Roman Catholics believe, that is transubstantiation.
因为不可能成为物质的肉和物质的血的。
Because it cannot be the physical body and blood of Jesus.
当主耶稣复活的时候，
when Jesus resurrected,
他已经没有物质的肉物质的血。
He no longer had a physical body or carried with him physical blood.
他复活以后是一个灵体。
In fact, when he resurrected, he was in a spiritual body.
不再受物质空间时间来限制的。
He was no longer limited by physical time and space.
所以他又怎么样在圣餐的时候让这个饼成为物质的肉，成为物质的血，叫我们吃这个物质的肉，物质的血呢？
If that is the case, how could he have, during the Holy Communion, changed the bread and the cup into his physical body and his physical blood, and then commanding the disciples to eat of his physical body and physical blood?
因此最合理的解释，那就是圣灵的运行之下，在灵里变化成为主的肉，主的血。
And therefore, the most reasonable explanation is that there is a change in spirit brought about by the Holy Spirit.
所以我们教会主张的是灵化说。
And therefore, what our church propound is,
不是物质的变化，是灵里的变化。
There's a spiritual change.
圣餐典礼被称为是圣礼。
The Holy Communion is known as a sacrament.
我们中文从圣礼这个字看不出它特别的意思，可是在原文或者英文呢，这个圣礼这个字本身就是代表说神圣的事物，或者说神秘的事物。
In Chinese, the word sacrament does not carry such a connotation, but in the original language and in English, the word sacrament carries with it the idea of a mystery.
如果这只是一个普通的象征，普通的怎么会说是一个神秘和神圣呢？
If this is just symbolic, why is it known as a sacrament? Because a sacrament is something that is divine and carries with it a mystery.
所以我们的解释是在圣灵的运行下，在灵里的变化，这真的是一个奥秘。
And therefore, for our church, our explanation is that there is a change in spirit brought about by the Holy Spirit, and this indeed is a mystery.
是我们的理智很难去了解。
It is something that our rational mind cannot accept.
但是我们相信主的话和主的解释。
But we believe in the words of Jesus and his explanation.
因此我们相信。
Therefore we believe.
圣餐典礼不只是纪念主的死。
The Holy Communion is not just a remembrance of His death.
更重要的是统领主的身体，主的血。
But more importantly, it is a communion in His body and in His blood.
让我们有永生，让我们将来有复活。
So that we can have eternal life and that in the future we will rise again.
因此我们必须完全遵照主所行的去行。
Therefore, we must hold completely to what Jesus commanded.
那你所领受的圣餐是不是按照主所行的去行？
The question is, the Holy Communion that you partake, is it according to the teachings of the Lord?
祈求主帮助我们。
May the Lord help us.
让我们都按照主所行的去行，来举办圣餐典礼。
Let us conduct the Holy Communion according to the instructions of Jesus.
我们请唱赞美诗三。